Mm-hmm. I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a Chesterfield cushioned nail effect just with gel polish. So we're going to work on a tip. I have this beautiful colour, which is like a plum. And it is this number, which is 657. This colour does have a name. It's called Cabernet. I'm going to do two coats. So I'll cure both layers as well. You can do this design in any colour you want. I'm just showing you how to do a simple cushioned effect with gel polish. Gonna pop that in the lamp, cure that. Second coat of colour. Look how rich that is. That's like $1 million rich. I'm gonna pop top coat on now. Now if you were doing this on a natural nail before you put the colour on, obviously you would put the base coat on. If you were doing it on an acrylic nail or a hard gel nail, you wouldn't need to put the base coat on. You'd go straight on with the colour just like I have on this tip. Cure that in the lamp now. Now that's cured, we're going to use the matte coat, and I'm going to not just going to slap this on, I'm going to pop this onto a palette so I can use it really controlled. Control! I'm going to show you two different ways. You can use a dotting tool or you can use a brush. I'll show you both ways. I'm going to start at the top and you're going to push it out into a cross shape first, and then you're going to make your little diamond. Done those three, I am going to cure those, and then because I've got those three down the middle, that is my starting point. It's easy to do it like this. Do not start from one corner and work your way down. Start directly down the middle of the nail. It's a lot easier. So what I'm going to do now here, I'm going to make my little cross. Yeah. Adding a little bit more of the matte into those two. I'm going to cure those. I don't want them to move anywhere. So I haven't added the extra matte top coat until I know it's going to go in the lamp. If I didn't, it's going to start going. It's going to start to move and fall. going to do one here, same shape. So what I'm going to do now is, again, up here, we need one. You can see I've started from the middle and I've done one side. I've fitted all the shapes in between each other. It's very important to keep them close but do not touch. So you can see that you have a border around each one of those cushions. I'm going to do exactly the same thing on the other side just to make it symmetrical. Now that's cured, I'm going to wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution. I'm just going to take the sticky layer off. I love it when I wipe over and this happens. It's magic, magic. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to use, you could either use nail glue, you could use Urban Graffiti top coat. I'm going to use Mega Gloss. I'm going to get a little bit of it, put it onto a palette. I have some of the micro beads here in gold. I think that would look very nice with this colour. And I'm going to, throw everything around. I'm going to use a dotting tool to just do a little dot of the, to just do a little dot of the Mega Gloss, pick up the micro beads as if they are the little buttons of the Chesterfield. I'm going to do that in all these little gaps, working my way down. I'm going to flash cure a few of them at a time. And they're easy to pick up because there's still a little bit of gel on the dotting tool. So that just picks up the beads really easily. Make sure they've not moved and they're all in the right place before you pop it into the lamp. There you are, that's a nail good enough to sit on. You could put your booty on that. There you are guys, I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. All the products I've used today are in the description box just down there. Don't forget, check us out on Facebook and Instagram and all that shebang. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.